The Swift Programming Language 5.6 Edition, book copyrighted by Apple and made available under the Creative Commons Attribution 4.0 International License. Typecasting. Typecasting is a way to check the type of an instance or to treat that instance as a different superclass or subclass from somewhere else in its own class hierarchy. Typecasting in Swift is implemented with the is and as operators. These two operators provide a simple and expressive way to check the type of a value or cast a value to a different type. You can also use typecasting to check whether a type conforms to a protocol, as described in Checking for Protocol Conformance. Defining a class hierarchy for typecasting. You can use typecasting with a hierarchy of classes and subclasses to check the type of a particular class instance and to cast that instance to another class within the same hierarchy. The three code snippets here define a hierarchy of classes and an array containing instances of those classes for use in an example of typecasting. The first snippet defines a new base class called MediaItem. This class provides basic functionality for any kind of item that appears in a digital media library. Specifically, it declares a name property of type string and an init name initializer. It is assumed that all media items, including all movies and songs, will have a name. The next snippet defines two subclasses of media item. The first subclass, movie, encapsulates additional information about a movie or film. It adds a director property on top of the base media item class with a corresponding initializer. The second subclass, song, adds an artist property and initializer on top of the base class. The final snippet creates a constant array called library, which contains two movie instances and three song instances. The type of the library array is inferred by initializing it with the contents of an array literal. Swift's type checker is able to deduce that movie and song have a common superclass of media item, and so it infers a type of array of media item for the library array. The items stored in library are still movie and song instances behind the scenes. However, if you iterate over the contents of this array, the items you receive back are typed as media item and not as movie or song. In order to work with them as their native type, you need to check their type or downcast them to a different type, as described later. Checking type. Use the type check operator is to check whether an instance is of a certain subclass type. The type check operator returns true if the instance is of that subclass type and false if it is not. This example defines two variables, movie count and song count, which count the number of movie and song instances in the library array. This example iterates through all items in the library array. On each pass, the for in loop sets the item constant to be the next media item in the array. Item is movie returns true if the current media item is a movie instance and false if it is not. Similarly, item is song checks whether an item is a song instance. At the end of the for in loop, the values of movie count and song count contain a count of how many media item instances were found of each type. Downcasting. A constant or variable of a certain class type may actually refer to an instance of a subclass behind the scenes. Where you believe this is the case, you can try to downcast to the subclass type with the typecast operator, as with question mark or as with exclamation mark. Because downcasting can fail, the typecast operator comes in two different forms. The conditional form, as with question mark, returns an optional value of the type you are trying to downcast to. The forced form, as with exclamation mark, attempts the downcast and force unwraps the result as a single compound action. Use the conditional form of the typecast operator as question mark when you are not sure if the downcast will succeed. This form of the operator will always return an optional value, and the value will be nil if the downcast was not possible. This enables you to check for a successful downcast. Use the forced form of the typecast operator as with exclamation mark only when you are sure that the downcast will always succeed. This form of the operator will trigger a runtime error if you try to downcast to an incorrect class type. This example iterates over each media item in library and prints an appropriate description for each item. To do this, it needs to access each item as a true movie or song and not just as a media item. This is necessary in order for it to be able to access the director or artist property of a movie or song for use in the description. In this example, each item in the array might be a movie or it might be a song. You do not know in advance which actual class to use for each item, and so it is appropriate to use the conditional form of the typecast operator as with question mark to check the downcast each time through the loop. The example starts by trying to downcast the current item as a movie. Because item is a media item instance, it is possible that it might be a movie. Equally, it is also possible that it might be a song, or even just a base media item. Because of this uncertainty, the as question mark form of the typecast operator returns an optional value when attempting to downclass to a subclass type. The result of item as question mark movie is of type optional movie. Downcasting to movie fails when applied to the song instances in the library array. To cope with this, the example uses optional binding to check whether the optional movie actually contains a value, that is, to find out whether the downcast succeeded. This optional binding is written if let movie equal item as question mark movie, which can be read as try to access item as a movie. If this is successful, set a new temporary constant called movie to the value stored in the returned optional movie. If the downcasting succeeds, the properties of movie are then used to print a description for the movie instance, including the name of its director. A similar principle is used to check for song instances and to print an appropriate description, including artist name, whenever a song is found in the library. Note, casting does not actually modify the instance or change its values. The underlying instance remains the same. It is simply treated and accessed as an instance of the type to which it has been cast. Typecasting for any and any object. Swift provides two special types for working with non-specific types. Any can represent an instance of any type at all, including function types. Any object can represent an instance of any class type. Use any and any object only when you explicitly need the behavior and capabilities they provide. It is always better to be specific about the types you expect to work with in your code. Here is an example of using any to work with a mix of different types, including function types and non-class types. The example creates an array called things, which can store values of type any. The things array contains two int values, two double values, a string value, a tuple of type double double, the movie Ghostbusters, and a closure expression that takes a string value and returns another string value. To discover the specific type of a constant or variable that is known only to be of type any or any object, you can use an is or as pattern in a switch statement's cases. This example iterates over the items in the things array and queries the type of each item with a switch statement. Several of the switch statement's cases bind their matched value to a constant of the specified type to enable its value to be printed. Note, the any type represents values of any type, including optional types. Swift gives you a warning if you use an optional value where a value of type any is expected. If you really do need to use an optional value as an any value, you can use the as operator to cast the optional to any, as shown here.